One of the hardest parts of life is when an intimate relationship, when a romantic relationship ends, and then we have to do that task called getting over that person. I've had to do this a few times throughout my life, and so I hope that in this video I can give you a few tips that can help you get over your ex. The very first step towards getting over an ex, and this is my personal opinion, this may not work for everyone. If you disagree, that's fine. For me, to get over an ex, I always want to keep a mindset of appreciation. I want to appreciate them for their time. I want to appreciate them for their effort. I want to appreciate them for what they gave to me. One of the ways that I was able to get over any relationship I've been in, and I'm not saying it was easy, but I am saying that it happened. And it happened because I always kept an appreciation for them. When I thought of them, the thoughts I would have would not be, oh, I miss them so much, I want to be back with them. It would be, I appreciate them for giving me what they gave me. I appreciate them for teaching me what they taught me. I appreciate them for being around when she was around. I had a high school sweetheart. I had a college sweetheart. I had a girl when I was 22, right? And then I had an older relationship when I was like 25, maybe, I don't know, 25, right? So I had all the phases, high school, college, right out of college, and then somewhat of an adult, right? None of those relationships, they didn't work out, but I'm friends with them all. We all have respect for each other. We all still have love for each other. Now, I'll tell you about my exes now. I have no connection to my high school sweetheart. Now, it's not because of something is wrong or we left each other on such a sour note. That's not the situation. The situation is we just haven't spoken. That's literally it. We haven't spoken. We haven't been in touch. We have no connection on social media or anything of that nature. If I saw her in Whole Foods tomorrow, we would talk for an hour and have a great conversation. And I hope she's doing well. I'm sure she will hope the same for me. Now, my second girlfriend in college, you know, we were together for years. Like, she was my best friend and still is one of my best friends to this day. We just talked last week for about an hour and a half. Because we still have respect for the bond and for the relationship. She caused me pain, I caused her pain. But we were able to forgive each other. We talked to each other about the pain after we were removed from it. We talked about it. I forgave her for what she did to me. She forgave me for what I did to her. We were able to understand that, like, we were young kids, but we had a lot of love for each other, right? And so we appreciated each other. The girl after that, let me see, who is that? that would be okay. So me and her, we're still friends to this day. I've seen her a few times since we've broken up. She's doing well. She's finally, so when I was like 22, 23 at that point, that's when we were dating, and she was at that point where she's trying to develop her career, and now she's in the career that she was trying to develop then. And I'm so proud of her for that. I'm so happy for her because she got to develop the career that she wanted when I was dating her. So I appreciate the journey that I saw while she was in school. I saw while she was studying. I saw while she was first trying to get clients. She does, I think it's called esthetician, like doing hair and stuff. And like, I saw when she was going through her journey to develop herself, to try to, you know, get to a place where she's at now. So I want nothing but happiness for her. You know, it's crazy to me how people want, you know, bad things to happen to people that they claim that they love or loved. I loved all of them. So why would I want anything bad to happen to them? You know? And then the fourth girl, that was the only one, to me, in my opinion, that was the only one that I would consider to be toxic. Now, maybe I need to do a whole episode on that relationship. But I think it was toxic for a couple of reasons. I think, let's see, let me think about this. I think I didn't listen to her. When I met her, she told me these exact words. She said, I'm not ready to be in a relationship. I'm not ready for anything. You know, I just got out of something that was really, really dark and really deep, and I need time. Now, me being a young guy, a conqueror, it's good. We good. We, right? That's what I told, like, we went on a date, and I told her. I was like, you know, on our first date, that's what she told me on the first date. And I should have listened to her, but I was just like, you know what? That's fine. Like, that's okay, because I can feel our connection. Like, I can feel our vibe. And I know you do too. And she's like, yeah, I do, but I'm just scared I'm gonna hurt you. And I was like, well, you know, why should we, why ignore a good thing? Like, we came together for a reason. Like, this is dope. I mean, this is only the first date, and it feels so good. So, like, let's continue it. I think we're at, like, IHOP or something, too. Like, we're having this deep conversation in, like, an IHOP at, like, 3 in the morning. In retrospect, I should have listened to her, because she was right. She wasn't healed. She wasn't healed from her past relationship, and she brought all that into the relationship with me. And now I'm also a young 20-year-old guy. I'm like 25 at the time, 24, something of that nature, 26. And so it's like, I'm trying to still find myself. And I'm in my career, and I'm trying to kind of establish my career. I'm trying to figure out where I want to be and what I want to do. So I'm in a transition stage, and she's in a healing stage. And those stages, for us, didn't work. Maybe for you guys, they might. I don't know. But for us, me being in a transition stage of trying to figure out where I wanted to be and who I wanted to be and what I wanted to do, and her trying to heal, and then us coming together, yes, there was a lot of love there. And I still have love for her now, but it was the timing wasn't really great for either one of us. But we tried. We tried. We gave it our best efforts. I can literally tell you that she tried her best and I tried my best. I know that for a fact. And so for me, that's closure. That's closure to me, knowing that we both tried our best with what we had. A lot of times I think people want to go back in these relationships and they want to change them. And you can't. You can't change it. Like, it was what it was. You know, it was what it was. And the only thing that you can do is change how you look at it. The only way you can get over it is to appreciate it for what it was. That's step number one, is to appreciate it. Step number two, if you are trying to get over an ex, if you're trying to get over a relationship, the best advice I can give you is to work on yourself. You have to work on yourself. I really recommend working on yourself. Increasing your knowledge of personal finances, right? Getting your money together, getting out of debt, working on your personal finances, right? Then on the second piece of that is, I want you to work on your physical fitness, work on your mobility, work on your flexibility, work on your strength, right? Work on your sleep hygiene, work on your hydration, work on the nutrition that you're choosing to put in your body. Work on developing yourself, work on getting better at communicating, work on getting better at listening, sharpen your skills within your job, right? All of this is getting yourself better. Don't look at it as you're getting yourself better for the next person. Look at it as you're getting yourself better for you. And when the next person comes, they most likely will vibrate at a higher level, because you have got yourself to a higher level of vibration through your activity, through your constant learning. Does that make sense to you? Okay. Now, the last tip I have for you. Now, I'm not a dating coach. I refuse to accept that title. I just have ideas about life, and I have observations and stories. I've seen a lot of dating coaches say things like, go fuck somebody else, go have sex with somebody else, go hook up with somebody else. I don't know if that advice is good. I don't know if it's bad. I don't know. I'll be flat out honest with you. I've done it. I've done that advice. And then I've done the opposite, where it's like, yo, I'm not hooking up with anybody for a year. I'm not dating. I'm not talking to anyone. I'm not texting. It's just me, and I'm working, and I'm grinding. And then I've also done the whole thing, like, hey, I just broke up. What, one night stand? I need to release this. I've done both, okay? For me personally, they both were fine. Okay, now I was at different points in my life, they both were fine. So I'm not gonna give you that advice. And I'm also not gonna say that advice is good or bad. I don't know. It's up to the person to determine what's best for them. But I can tell you this for sure. For sure, I can tell you this. Number three, you have to develop more connections. If you are trying to get over your ex, you have to develop more connections. Now, what I mean by that is, you can dive deeper into your business and network more. You can meet more people at the job. Maybe you work with 40 people, but you need to start meeting people who work in the corporate office or who work in HR. Develop yourself more, right? A lot of the times when you go through a breakup, you shut down and you retreat. And I'm challenging you not to do that. I'm challenging you to put yourself out there more, to meet more people in your business and your organization. Because if you're already taking my other advice, which is to work on yourself, as you work on yourself and develop yourself and you develop your skills and you develop your work ethic and you make yourself a better person and you make yourself vibrate higher, new business opportunity is going to come to you, right? So meet more people. On the second tip, from a social standpoint, you want to meet more people. If you were in a long-term relationship, odds are you came out of that relationship and you don't have many friends. You maybe have one or two best friends. So I want you to deepen the connection with them. I want you to see your best friends more. If they're in relationships, be the third wheel if they don't mind. Figure out how you can service them more. Figure out how you can help them more. And then I want you to be more social. I want you to go out to events more. Go out to dances. Go out to networking events. Go out to professional mixers. Go out to the gastro pubs and to the bars, to bowling. I know a lot of people are going to jump on online dating, and I'm not going to tell you not to do that. Because online dating, I can make a video or podcast about that too. I think there's value there. That's my opinion has changed. I haven't used online dating, but my opinion has definitely changed because I think there's a lot of value there. But nothing trumps in person. Nothing trumps seeing people's energy. Nothing trumps seeing someone face to face. Nothing trumps that. And if you're trying to get over one person, meet 1,000 people. And 1,000 people, it doesn't have to be romantic. Like I said, meet people in your business, right? Increase and add value to the relationships that you already have, your friendships you already have. Add value to your family. Meet more of your family members. Be with your family members more. Spend more time there. And then also be more social. And being more social doesn't mean I'm going out looking for a date. It can literally be you and your friends just going out playing ping pong or playing, you know, batting cages. Whatever that may be, I want you to be more social. Guys, my name is Sylvester Mcnutt III. I'm a best-selling author of 8 books, host of the Free Your Energy podcast. If you're brand new here, I hope you got value. I hope you got value today. I hope you got something that you need. I try to give realistic, tangible, you know, practical ideas. I try to talk about things I've experienced. I don't talk about things I don't know anything about. So I hope you got value here today. If you're listening on the podcast, SoundCloud, iTunes, Spotify, I just want you to know that there is a video format on YouTube. I would appreciate if you came to my YouTube. Have over 300 videos on YouTube for you. If you guys are on YouTube or IGTV, feel free to subscribe as well so you can catch me on the go. The Free Your Energy podcast is on SoundCloud, iTunes, and Spotify. And if you guys use Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook, yes, I said Twitter. I don't know Twitter. Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, feel free to find me on there. Username Sylvester Mcnutt. I post on those every day. I'm on LinkedIn, too. You guys on LinkedIn? LinkedIn is kind of weird. I'm not going to lie to you. I go on there. I post on there, but it's kind of weird. It's kind of weird to me. Maybe I can make an episode about that. Guys, thank you for this episode. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening to the Free Your Energy podcast. The next one I'm going to talk about is how you can be a better employee. Or if you're an entrepreneur, I'm an entrepreneur. These same tips can apply to you. So thank you for listening to the Free Your Energy podcast. Free Your Energy.